economics editor, Stephen Keplis, in our studio today. How are you, Stephen?
Good, good. How are you doing?
And we have a big story to open with, which is Apple's big announcement in Latin America. There have been a lot of online rumors about that, and I know Univision News is doing a developing story on it. Can you clarify a bit for us?
Yeah, actually, our reporters are working on a piece, but there hasn't been an announcement yet. But the rumors are that Apple will announce that basically iTunes in Latin America, but with music. There's a few versions now of iTunes in Latin America, but they don't have music. The rumors that this would happen December 8th throughout the region, and it's a pretty big development because it's been one of the few regions without iTunes and music.
Piracy there is huge because of that.
And piracy is a huge issue. So this what it will do is it will offer it'll be a positive thing for Latin American artists. It'll offer them a regulated market to sell their music online. So I think it's a positive development, and then we'll see what happens, but there's a lot of rumors going around. So I think it's...
We'll keep you posted on that developing story. And as long as we're, talking about Latin America, what are the hot economic Latin American stories this week?
Sure. We're stay tuned to Univision News and our Tumblr page, because we just are putting out a list of the top stories. But the top three of the top stories that I've seen this week that I think are pretty interesting are, first, Colombian President Santos met with Venezuela's President Hugo Chavez. They signed a number of agreements, basically reinstituting a lot of the trade that they had previously that was canceled, during the various disputes over the last few years. This is a really positive thing for Colombia and probably for Venezuelans as well, that, should be able to get some of these cheaper Colombian goods into the market. Mm-hmm. That was a big deal. Another thing is this report from the UN saying that poverty in Latin America is actually the lowest it's been for 20 years, and it went down in the last couple of years despite sort of the global economic recession, which is, significant. And finally, there was an interesting report about Latin American renewable energy, sort of saying that solar and wind power in Latin America is set for a boom. So that's kind of developing. And
good news.
Yeah, good news for once. So to wrap up, I want to take the opportunity to ask you a few questions as our local art expert. This week in Miami, it's Art Basel. You've been around doing some reporting. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about the Latin American art that's out there and what the market is like at the moment.
Well, it's Art Basel's 10th anniversary, and it has really revived Miami, not only Basel, but all the satellite art fairs that have been going around the city, Pulse, Red Dot, Aqua, Tribal Art Miami. So it's really amazing what it has done for the city. In terms of Latin American art, we're seeing that Latin American art is being, collected by global collectors, and the Latin American collectors are also coming here determined to acquire good quality artwork. The blue chip Latin American artists like Botero, for example, like Claudio Bravo, Manolo Valdez, they always do great and they'll continue to do great. I spoke with a representative from Marlborough Gallery today, and he said that in the first hour, the crowds just swarmed in, and he sold three pieces per artist, basically. And that, for that to happen with this economy, it means that people would rather have their money on the wall, instead of having it in a fund or in a bank.
Sure. So it's a bull market for Latin American art.
Exactly. And we'll keep you posted on the up and coming artists and the blue chip artists on the Tumblr page. And it's exciting. It ends this weekend. We'll see what happens.
Great.
Thank you so much.